Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we will take a look at some new I Don't Work Here Lady stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
The first story is titled No, I actually don't work here, dude. I was at my local hardware store minding my own business when a guy came up to me wearing a rather cross expression. Before I say anything, he asks, where are your toggles? And don't say you don't work here because I know you do. Keep in mind, the uniform was a red shirt with the company name, and I was in a different colored t-shirt and shorts. Now, I knew exactly where the toggles were, but given his rather curt accusation, I decided to mess with him. I asked if he meant the drywall kind. He rolled his eyes and said yes. So I led him, in a very roundabout way, to the electrical section and to toggle switches. He was irate at this point and said that he was going to go ask someone who's actually competent. To which I replied, make sure they actually work here this time, prick the kicker. Drywall toggles were in the same aisle I originally was in. The next story is titled, yes miss, I am 100% positive that I am college student and not one of your students. So this story occurred last spring during my last quarter of college. I lived in this rented house about a mile away from campus, so I would walk every day for classes. On one nice spring day, while walking to campus, I encountered one of the many school tours that occurs throughout the school years coming out of the dorms. So the pathway from the dorm to the school was long, narrow sidewalk, and so the tour group took up most of the sidewalk. Some students walked on the road to get around them. Since I wasn't in the rush to get to class, I slowly walked with the group. As we got the center of campus, I split with the group and went my way in a different direction. Casually walking and listening to some music, I felt someone grabbing my shoulder and I turned in confusion. I was met with two older ladies, looking angry at me. This is the conversation that occurred. L1 is Lady 1 and L2 is Lady 2, while M is me. L1, excuse mister, shouldn't you go back to your group? Me looking confused. L1, don't give me that look, I saw you walking away from our tour group. Lady 2 comes in with an angry demeanor. L2, why are you like this? You are taking advantage of the privilege you were given. Now you walk back to your group right now. At this point I am beyond confused. M, sorry miss, I don't understand what you are saying, what group are we talking about? After that remark, L2 was getting red. L2, what group? The group we ride on the bus together with and tour this school with. At this point I realize what was happening. M, oh, I believe you are mistaking me for a student in your tour group. I am sorry you are mistaken, I attend this school and I am about to graduate. Asterisk L1 gave me this oh face. L1, oh, I am sorry to bother you. While L2 was taken aback by what I said. L2, so you are telling me you don't attend blah blah high school for a senior college tour? M, I am a 100 positive I am not a high schooler. L2, I don't trust you, let me see your ID. I gave her my old high school ID, college ID and state ID. Asterisk both L1 and L2 quickly apologized and told me I looked like one of their students in the group. I told them it wasn't a problem and they left. One of my friend from my friend group saw the whole situation and told everyone in our friend group. Now every time I messed up on something they go, why are you like this? The next story is titled, my mum is a Karen, a little backstory. My mother is a full-blown Karen and I try my best to show her right, but it seems to just be ingrained in her nature. Like calls the manager, idioties about people in front of them and just all around clueless and ugh. We went on a trip to Vietnam a couple of years back and did a tour bus thing for a couple of days. We met everyone else we were traveling with at a restaurant in Hanoi. Everyone in the group was white except one man, K, who arrived with his Australian partner and Mill. They sat down with us and Kay was chatting away with us, told us he was originally from Taiwan, now lived in Australia. However, after a while of small talk with everyone, the guide hadn't turned up yet. My mother, who seems to think all Asians are the same, asks him where he is taking us on our trip. Everyone else around the table stared wide-eyed as we all knew he was just another tourist. Kay goes, haha, sorry, I'm on this trip just like you. However, my mother was in Karen mode and continues with, well yes, but where is our first stop? And what activities will we be doing? I then tap her on the arm and say, Mum, he is just a tourist like us. She goes, oh, and shuts up, but Kay lets out a loud, ha. Not all Asians look the same, darling. It put her in her place and I'm glad. They got on well the rest of the trip though. The next story is titled, Woman Thought I Was Doing Community Service. I was at a campsite waiting for the sun to set so I can take pictures of the night sky. I wanted to include a picture with the landscape, but there was a few rubbish and dead plants. So I begin sweep and clear rubbish of the area I wanted to look clean for the shot. Afterwards, I sat down, put on headphones and ate a snack. Then a woman came up to me and asked where my supervisor was. I hated her tone so I gave her a dirty look and ignore her. She very rudely continued to ask me the same question. I told her to leave me alone and go away. She walked away in anger, then turned back to say, I can see why you are in jail, mate. Then I realized she thought I was doing community service. When the sun started to set, I set up my camera gear. So she decided to move her four-wheel drive and park where I'm obviously aiming to try and block me. When I aimed somewhere else she would move there. I had to juke her to get my shot. Why the duck are people so miserable? Edit, I tried to take the picture of the Milky Way but my camera could only expose for 15 seconds. 15 seconds wasn't enough and you could only see some stars, not the Milky Way. It was so dark that I had to wait for around 5 minutes my eyes to adapt to be able to see it. Apparently in order to take the picture of the Milky Way, you need a tripod that can track the stars' movement, and a camera that can expose for a very long time. The next story is titled, Take Off Your Name Tag Before Shopping. So to preface, this happened a few months ago. My work requires me to wear a white collared shirt with the company logo stitched on along with a name tag. I'd just finished a 14-hour shift and I needed to get some groceries before getting home still wearing my uniform name tag and all. I'm walking to the dairy section when I hear an old lady behind me, excuse me, young man. Could you tell me where the flour is? She must have been at least 80 and I happened to know where the flour was so I decided to help her. Here you go, ma'am. That's when another customer starts snapping and saying, hey, to get my attention. She will be Al for annoying lady. Al, get some butter for me while you're at it, I'm in a hurry. Me, please ask someone else, I don't. Al, I don't have time for this, just get it for me. Me, I don't work here, ask someone else. Al, clearly you do, you're wearing the uniform, and you helped that woman over there, so stop being rude. At this point, I realize I won't be able to convince her that I don't work here so I start walking away. Al is having none of that and starts snapping again while yelling, hey, I'm not done with you, I need to see your manager. I continue walking pretending to not hear her. I'm almost at the registers when she puts her hand on my shoulder as to stop me. Are you deaf? I'm talking to you dumbass. That's when I get lucky because the manager of the store happens to be by the registers. So he gets over to us and asks, is there something wrong here? Al, this idiot refuses to help me, I tried telling her that I don't work here, manager, ma'am, he doesn't work here, Al, then why is he wearing the uniform? You're just trying to get him off the hook, manager, look at the logos, they're not the same. That's when she goes silent. She just looks for a second at our shirts and then she walks off. The manager says sorry to me and walks off towards Al. The sweet old lady overheard all of this and came over to me and said, I'm so sorry, I thought you worked here. The next story is titled, I do work there, but this is my home. So when I was 16 I worked in our local pharmacy, chemist with my brother, 20 at the time. I was just a sales assistant and he was a dispenser, could put the medicine in the bag but had to have a pharmacist sign it. Anyway, because it was local to our home, we knew a lot of the people that came in for their prescriptions. Neighbors, friends and just people we passed on the walk to work. Like most pharmacies, we were closed on Sundays. Then at 9 in the morning I heard the doorbell ring and answered. It was a lady who lived down the road from us but we didn't really know. Let's call her Mrs. B. The conversation went as follows. Me, hi. Mrs. B, you work at the pharmacy, don't you? Me, yes, Mrs. B. Mrs. B, okay, good, well my husband needs his medicine. He needs to take it today. Me, I'm sorry Mrs. B, but there's nothing I can do. The pharmacy is closed and I can't just take medicine without the pharmacist. Mrs. B, what about your brother? He deals with the prescriptions. Me, he's not able to do it either. We need a pharmacist and it is closed. You can call emergency number, but that's all we can help you with. Mrs. B, but you both work there. My husband will die if he doesn't get his medicine. Me internally, should have got it yesterday then. Me, I'm sorry but honestly we can't do anything. Mrs. B, you need to do it now. Or I will call your manager on Monday with a complaint against the both of you. Me, please feel free to. As I said, there's nothing that can be done. All you can do is call the emergency number. I do work at the pharmacy, as does my brother, but this is our home. We aren't working today. Mrs. B, I will never use your pharmacy again and you will be fired for this. Then she proceeded to storm off. Needless to say, I wasn't fired. Neither was my brother. In fact, our manager couldn't stop laughing when she got the call on Monday. Her husband didn't die. He's still alive today, 5 years later. A lot of people try the death card to get their medicine faster. It doesn't work unless it is urgent, and a little secret, we know if it's urgent. The next story is titled, A Return to My Box Office Roots. My first job out of college was doing customer service for a data company. Before then, I had worked at the local theater company during college and had mastered dealing with cranky old people. On one of my first days at the data company, I got a call from someone looking for the city's Opera House box office. Confused, I googled the Opera House and found out their box office number was one digit off from my work phone number. I continued getting calls for the Opera House throughout the time I worked there and would usually tell the person the correct number and they'd hang up. But there was one time where the caller couldn't grasp that I wasn't the box office. The woman who called that day was definitely an older woman, based on the sound of her voice. I tried to explain that I wasn't the box office and gave her the Opera House's phone number. She was confused and said that's the number she dialed, and she sounded a little panicked. I tried explaining the situation again, but I could tell she wasn't getting it. She was quiet for a moment and said, I just want tickets for Friday night. So I put on my best customer service voice and asked for her name, how many tickets she wanted, and what section she wanted to sit in. She gave me the info and I told her I was going to put her on hold. I put my work phone on hold and then called the Opera House on my cell. Thankfully they had tickets available for Friday night, so I explained the situation and gave them her name. They said she could pay when she picked the tickets up at the box office. I took the old woman off hold and told her that her tickets would be waiting for her at the box office on Friday night. She was thrilled and told me all about how she was to take her grandson to his first opera. The next story is titled, MIL's friend thought I was a crazy waitress. My husband, BF at the time of the story, and I had our first date at a hot pot restaurant in downtown Boston. Flash forward a couple of years, my mil loves this restaurant and when they would visit us in town we would go. One night they invited a close friend of theirs and her fiancé to join us, we'll call her K. They all get to the restaurant first and then my boyfriend and I join. We didn't do introductions since I had met them a few times at family events. Since Kay and her fiancé had never had hot pot, I was more than happy to show them how to order, how to cook and eat their meal. Everyone had a blast, we were laughing and joking and drinking scorpion bowls. The meal seemed to go fine and after my in-laws pay and get their car pulled around, they offer us a ride home. Our apartment is walking distance but it was winter so we accepted. As I get into the car, Kay stares at me like I'm a crazy person. She says loudly, "Why is the waitress coming home with us?" We all look at her like she's the crazy one. My mil says, Kay, this is his girlfriend, they've been living together for 3 years. You've met her before. Kay is flabbergasted and a bit embarrassed. Apparently she thought I was a very enthusiastic waitress, I'm Asian so hence the confusion, who had pretty much invited herself to dinner and drinks and was just getting into random customers' cars. We all had a good laugh and chalked it up to the fact that they had been to a bar prior to dinner and she may have had a few more drinks than everyone else. She's a very sweet woman and we have a great relationship, but it's a fun story to bring up when we see her. The next story is titled, I'm not a paramedic though, this happened today while I was at work, and I decided to create an account to let you guys know about it. I'm a cop and was mistaken for a paramedic. I have basic first aid and have a defib in my cruiser, but that's it. Often cops and paramedics get called to the same call even if technically it's purely medical and there's nothing job specific for me to do that the paramedics can't do. Often I'll hang out for a little while longer after it's been determined I'm not really needed just in case the paramedics change their mind due to the patient getting violent or something. Of note, we have similar uniforms, but I have a red stripe down my pants, carry a gun, and they have word police in huge letters on my back and the front of my vest, while paramedics have paramedic written on them. If you're literate, and no paramedics don't carry guns, you can tell the difference. Also, if a cop tells you that they're not a paramedic, that should be a strong hint too. Today I was on scene when a kid started having some sort of medical emergency where he couldn't breathe properly. Paramedics show up lights and sirens and get him into the back of their ambulance. They left the lights on as they're blocking a lane. Once they get the kid in the ambulance, I'm standing outside waiting for them to head off. My cruiser was parked a couple meters from where I was standing as well. A lady comes up to us and goes, "You need to turn off those lights." And I reply with, "They aren't my lights, they're paramedics, and they're a little busy right now, probably saving a life." Lady replies with, "Those lights can cause a seizure. How dare you put people in danger like that? That's so irresponsible." Well, I'm not a paramedic, I'm a cop, so they're not mine. I gestured to my vest, which says in huge white letters on navy blue police. I looked around. The kid's family was standing at the other side of the ambulance and were basically the only other people there. A few people are in the area were paying no mind to us at all, and this lady herself was definitely not having a seizure in my non-medically professional medical opinion. Look, the lights are on for a reason. It's for driver safety, to alert drivers that there's an ambulance in the middle of the road. You aren't having a seizure and neither is anyone else, so if you don't mind, please move along. I hate crowding at scenes. Some of this kid's family was close by and they did not need random strangers causing a commotion and adding more stress to an already stressful situation. "I cannot believe how rude you are," she yells back, "I'm going to complain to your boss. You can definitely tell my boss I didn't turn off ambulance lights. My badge number is XXXXX. If the lights are pissing you off so much, you are welcome to leave. You're in a public area free for people to come and go in." Unbelievable. She stomped off after that, which was good. I haven't yet received that complaint. Probably because I'm not a paramedic. The next story is titled, "The Restaurant, the Karen and the Spatula." So this happened 2 days ago during my lunch break. While the Karen screeching was not directed at me, I was able to observe it all go down firsthand. Backstory, I have been going to the same restaurant, for lunch, for the past 2 months. It's a small place, but the food is amazing and prices are low. As any regular, I eventually got pretty friendly with the staff and the waiters. I tip well and always try to be smiling and nice, they deserve it. As such, I know everyone who works there and the manager's girlfriend. She comes in from time to time to have lunch around the same time I do, and we greet each other with a nod and a smile. That's all the backstory you need, now to the show. As usual, I arrive at around 1 p.m. and see the Karen walking just slightly behind me with her kid. I open the door to the restaurant and hold it so that they can pass. I'll let you guess if she said thank you or not. We go in and the restaurant is packed. There are only 3 open tables, so Karen and her kid take one and I the other. Literally a minute later, the manager's girlfriend, GF from now on, walks in. She goes up to the bar and talks with her boyfriend, briefly. Due to the chaos, both of the waiters are overwhelmed and GF helps one of them carry a set of trays to a table. She is cool like that and sits down on the last remaining table. Admittedly, service was kind of slow, but due to the sheer amount of people, it was understandable. Well, understandable for me, not the Karen. At some point, she just scoffs and bolts up walking to GF's table. "Karen, excuse me, can we order?" GF, caught off guard, "I'm sorry, what?" "Karen, can we order? We have been waiting for 10 minutes. GF, "You will have to ask a waiter, I don't work here. "Karen, of course you do. I saw you carry trays. "GF, that was just to help. "Karen, and now you are taking your break? You just came in. How can you be so lazy?" GF, "Seriously, ma'am, I don't work here." "Karen, bullcrap. I saw you. You have to take my order." At this point, a waiter manages to get to them. Meanwhile, I can see her daughter literally trying to unsubscribe from existence. "Waiter, ma'am, is there a problem here?" "Karen, this lazy idiot won't take my order." "Waiter, she doesn't work here, I can." Karen cuts him off. "Karen, I saw her working. I want to talk to your manager. She can't behave like that." The waiter just shrugs and asks the manager to come. "Manager, ma'am, what's going on?" "Karen, she refuses to serve me. You have to discipline her right now." "Manager, without ducking blinking, I will be sure to spank her with the hardest spatula we have later, but at the moment she doesn't work here and can't help you." Waiter here will be happy to take your order. Karen is just sitting there, mouth gaping, as if she was struck by the lightning of Zeus himself. The restaurant is quiet, GF is blushing a bit, but smiling. I am doing my best to not laugh out loud and failing. You can hear muffled chuckles from other tables. After about 20 seconds, the Karen huffs and drags her poor kid out of the restaurant. I tipped a lot that day. The next story is titled, Teacher Threatens to Get Me Fired, I Don't Work or Go to That School. My mum was the principal's secretary at a middle school in Pennsylvania. During summer vacation, I would go in and help her get mailings out to students for the next school year. I attended the rival middle school. I was 14. I would bring a movie and my roller skates and skate around the empty halls. I was eating lunch in the school library, just relaxing, and a teacher who was getting his classroom ready for the next year thrust some papers at me and told me to stop eating and get off my fat ass and take them to the office. I just laughed and said, bring them yourself. He got all huffy and started to stutter and said, duck, you grabbed up the papers, I believe it was a schedule for the upcoming year, and left. He stormed into the office, which was just across in the hall. He started yelling at my mum that her assistant was a lazy fat idiot, .q mama bear, .. She stood up and got really close to his face and said quite loudly, I don't have an assistant, if you mean my daughter you would be best to just turn around and walk away. And the last I saw of him was him leaving the office and scurrying down the hall looking very pale. I don't know how he thought I was an assistant. Point one, I'm like 14. Point two, I'm wearing roller skates. .. And school secretaries don't have assistants. This happened like 26 years ago, so I may be off on some details. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel and post some bear emojis in the comments.